you know, these are. This is the last year of an administration, election. It's just like this is a year that it just keeps on giving, and certainly Sarah Palin is one of the sources that keep on giving. How about this story about Levi Johnson's mother being arrested for drugs and then them trying to delay the arrest for so long?
It's pretty crazy, Pat, but I'm going to start out right here by saying I'm actually kind of sad to say this, but I think I owe Sarah Palin an apology. Mm. And not just her, but like pretty much the entire state of Alaska. Like you're saying, this comes from the story a couple weeks ago that Sarah Palin's daughter's baby's father's mother was arrested for drugs up in Wasilla. And again, if you misplaced your Palin family scorecard, the woman arrested, it's Sherry Johnston, who's the mother of Levi Johnston, and Levi is the father of Sarah Palin's daughter's Bristol's recently born baby Trip. We're on the Springer show again, Pap. It's crazy. It's just like
no. The only thing we're missing is people throwing chairs and just the regular Jerry Springer scene. Just follows these people around, doesn't it? I mean, it's crazy.
No, but when I heard that she was arrested at her home, you know, as part of an undercover drug investigation, I thought what I'm guessing probably 90% of those who are listening to this thought. I thought, obviously, she's been arrested for crystal meth. So I bet you she's running a meth lab in her house. Yeah. It seems obvious, but I was wrong, Pap. It turns out she wasn't running a meth lab. In fact, it wasn't meth at all. The drug was actually the painkiller OxyContin.
Well, you know, this is a woman who's listened to Rush Limbaugh for years, I'm sure. So,
exactly,
I mean,
exactly. So maybe Palin can give Rush Johnston's phone number because maybe Rush needs a new dealer for Oxy or something like that.
You know, the worst thing about this story to me, though, is the way that the government just, you know, they delayed the arrest warrant. They delayed the investigation. Tell us that part of the story.
Well, what's crazy is, like, yeah, it's actually come out in an email from one of the investigators, a guy named Kyle Young. He actually reported it to his union for the police up there that the investigation was actually delayed, he says, for political reasons, mm-hmm. which obviously with the election, the story of Johnston being arrested for drugs, it certainly wouldn't help the Palins, and we obviously know Sarah has a whole lot of ties with the cops, with the whole Troopergate scandal. The cops up there kind of know probably not to mess with her. Mm. So
you know, but what if this had been just any, you know, any urban black kid, you know, caught with...
He would have been taken down in a matter of seconds.
Of course. Caught with a bag of Panama Red, you know. Totally different standard there. This was delayed months, apparently, so it didn't have to reflect on this buffoon Sarah Palin, whose life and family and just every experience this woman's had in the last 12 years looks so dysfunctional, and this is just one of those other issues, isn't it?
Well, I mean, they do call OxyContin hillbilly heroin. That kind of does reflect around the people up there.
Now.
Exactly, we're in Alaska Deliverance and stuff here.
Yeah,
so.
but it came to surface, and now we'll just see where it goes. I just think while we're on Palin. What do you think of this pitch that hey she's going to be viable candidate in 2012? I'm not seeing it.
I'm crossing my fingers that she is the nominee. It's going to come to one of the things we're going to talk about a little later if we talk maybe the next show we'll talk about Chip Saltsman. It's the battle for Republicans right now is where they're going to go now.
Yeah.
Are they going to try to evolve into the 21st century, or are they going to devolve into their kind of racist goober souls that's there?
I interviewed James Carville not long ago, and he says that they can't help themselves. They'll keep evolving that way.
I think they're, you know, and I'm crossing my fingers that this is the end. They're going to be doomed to be like a party that's just strictly like a regional fringe party.
Like the American Whig Party that disappeared.
Precisely.
Okay, so you want to talk about Saltsman. You know, here you go. Chip Saltsman, Barack the Magic Negro. This is a guy, Republican Party, that says, hey, yeah, this is somebody we would like heading up our party.
The RNC, exactly. Yeah. Now Chip Saltsman, he was the head of the Tennessee Republicans. He actually worked with Bill Frist. He was I believe the chair of Mike Huckabee's campaign.
Right.
Now Chip, being the holly jolly man that he is, sent out as Christmas presents this last year, CDs with the song called Barack the Magic Negro.
Right.
Yeah, it's because nothing says,
it's a disgust.
Know,
I mean, you know, it's such a disgusting song that it's only the ditto head crowd, those folks that really do believe Rush Limbaugh is a genius.
Exactly. I mean,
that listen
made,
to that and go, oh, wow, this is great for
it
us.
It was made famous on Rush's show. Because really, though, nothing does say Merry Christmas like blatant racism.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not like Jesus was dark-skinned or anything like that. So it's clearly, it's a holiday song. Now, and then you'd think that now Saltsman, you know, having shown his racist stripes, you know, his chances of winning in a normal world would be bad. But again, mm-hmm. we're talking about Republicans who were just going crazy. And reports are actually showing that this story is actually helping Saltsman with his campaign.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was just going to say. Yeah, Mike Duncan, who's the past chairman, you know, he says that this is outrageous. He was shocked. He was appalled. Newt Gingrich.
Literally, they're splitting in half where, like, half of Republicans are going, yeah, we are at least smart enough to know this is bad politics, while the other half is going, oh, there's nothing wrong with this.
Well, let's see what they've lost. Okay, they don't have youth. I mean, less than 22% of anybody in the range of 18 years old to 28 years old voted for the Republicans.
Mm-hmm.
That was first. The minorities, there's like, what was it, like some outrage, almost, barely over 15%.
Exactly. I mean, it's clear where it's headed. I mean, Chip is empowering, I mean, like Obama's empowering Democrats, Chip is empowering Republicans all around America to embrace who they are.
It's like they can't do the math.
Say, we are white racists and proud.
Yeah, it's like they can't do the math, and that's what's so encouraging here. They really can't do the math. They don't understand that. Take a look at Obama right now.
Mm-hmm.
Do you really think he cares about the solid South? He could care less. He's given in on Alabama, Mississippi, Georgia, Louisiana. He knows that he has a new strategy to win. It's the Western states, and
Western states, but also he was also smart enough to adopt Howard Dean's strategy of going, you know, everywhere and appealing and putting offices everywhere. That again, like you know, I'm from Omaha, Nebraska, and I talked about this the last time I was on Ring of Fire, where he got an electoral vote out of Nebraska, and the fact that that's how you actually really do build something for the long run, where you know you do have voters in Nebraska who are going to vote, and even if they don't go to the president, you can get a House seat in a certain area. You know, there are pockets everywhere that if you think of, you know, think of one America, it's a great strategy. And
well, I mean, and it's working. And to me, what I love about it is just such a snub to the South. I live down here. These people, they've only seen how they're going to be abused in years to come. Matt, let's take a break. We're going to be right back with some more of the weird stories that, you know, they just keep getting better. So stay tuned. We'll be back.
Well, doing the news every morning it's a lot of work. I mean, it's not just the news itself. Getting ready alone is a lot of work. It's a 2-hour process, probably. You know, I wake up around 5 o'clock every day, you know, to stay in shape. You know, and then there's the makeup, the hair. It's work. I mean, look at this. I don't wake up looking like this. It doesn't just happen. It takes a little effort.